I grew up in an extremely small town in quite literally the middle of nowhere, Nebraska, where there's just not really anything going on. You know, there's like cows and cornfields and like churches, and that's about it. Growing up, my family would take me to see the Nutcracker every year, which was the first ballet that most people will ever see in their lifetime. And what really drew me towards it was how just beautiful and pure and graceful everything was. There was no ugly, there was no bad. It was just the most pure form of humanity that there is. When I was 13, I attended my first ballet intensive. I knew right away that this was going to be my life. The next year, at 14, I was accepted into an extremely prestigious ballet program in New York City. Going from being a normal kid in Nebraska to being a ballet dancer living on their own in an apartment in a big city was a huge change. Like, you have to be on your A game all the time while you're also just trying to figure out, oh my gosh, what am I doing? Like, how do I do laundry? How do I cook? How do I know how to take the train? I was terrified, but also excited, anxiously awaiting all of the new opportunities that were awaiting me. When I was 18, I began to audition for other professional companies. I was then offered a contract to come dance in San Diego. When I finally got what I thought would be a dream opportunity, it was nothing like what I expected it to be. I danced and danced and danced until I couldn't feel my body anymore. The pressure that there was to be such an unattainable thing was so intense that no one could handle it. I developed an eating disorder to the point where I couldn't even recognize myself anymore. I endured intense emotional and physical abuse. They didn't want you to have any type of fat on you whatsoever. They didn't want you to look like a real person or a real woman, especially. It felt like the world was closing in on me. I was lost. One day I was called into a meeting. I was told that my body was too womanly and that I would never be a real ballet dancer because of it. And that's when I decided I was done. It was terrifying to leave what felt like my one sense of security as a dancer, but it also gave me the opportunity to find myself as an artist and as a person again. I'm at a crossroads in my life, and there are so many directions I could go. It almost feels like it did when I was 13, that fresh surge of excitement. And knowing that there's a lot of opportunities just right ahead of you, but you just don't quite know what they are yet. But one thing I know is that I will always dance. I will always be a ballerina.